Happy TGIF, everybody. It's Cody here from Amazing ATS, and today on our company drive, we are going to be featuring Old Dominion Freight Lines. And yes, you guys are not seeing things. That is a 4x2 chassis. And we are in the Peterbilt 579. Of course, we've got the Old Dominion doubles behind us. And Evan, how are you doing today? Welcome to the live stream. Right now, we are sitting down here in Las Cruces, and since this is an LTL carrier, none of my loads today are probably going to go over 200 miles unless absolutely necessary. So without any further waiting, let's climb into the truck and get down the road. We are going to be going up to UPS there in Albuquerque. Now, also, I believe we are running a PACCAR engine in this, along with a 10-speed transmission. No 13s or 18s today. And if I could drive without hitting the fence, that would be even better. Guys out there have a good week, yes or no? And oh my god, I need to stop stalling the truck. Hello, Coda. Make sure you push the clutch in. When you stop, it will stop. It will not then stall out on you. And if I could actually talk today, that would be even better too. Kenworth, long time no see. How are you doing today? Are you ready to get back behind the wheel? much ever exciting happens where I live. So basically, I mean, I'm born by Interstate 80, like a mile away from there. And about the worst thing that happens here is a pileup in the middle of winter. And that's basically caused by cars, because they do not know how to drive. Lieutenant Colonel, thank you so much for that hosting. And, what type of mod are you looking for? Well, the new update of ATS did give us the Tioga Pass through the Yellowstone National Park. We did get trailer cables. Truckers MP is now updated for 1.31 also. It is going good, Lieutenant Colonel. Well, GT Mike just released a T800 yesterday, I believe, or was it Wednesday? I believe it was Wednesday that he released a T800. We do have the 900B, which is very similar to what we have in game, just a shorter and wider nose on it. Actually running a traffic density mod today. Oh, sweet. I was there last year. I went down to the Air and Space Museum. Much longer before we get Arizona, hopefully by the end of summer. Oh, I'm sure that echoed pretty good. Did I say Arizona? Oh, I meant to say Oregon. Sorry. Yeah, apparently it's Friday. My brain has pretty much shut down. I am done with work for the weekend. So, yeah, we're going to blame it on Coda having a lack of a brain. That might be because of this mod that I'm using, actually. For some odd reason, it looks like they do have 10 doubles on that rear axle instead of only one. What the hell is the holdup up there? Do we have an accident? Nope, just a car that's refusing to move. be sitting here for a while. Yeah, we're gonna do that the easy way because they are not gonna move. Hey, Martin, how are you doing today? Hey, I did look at Discord. How in the heck did you fall through a tidbit there in Wilmington? I don't think that's been updated yet. At least not for trailer connections. I checked the SES forums maybe 20 minutes ago and I didn't see a post about it being updated. And Coda, watch where the heck you're going. So you have an updated version with trailer cables and everything? I had the fix so I can see the truck in the dealership. I was waiting for an updated version for Viper to release. That's because SES changed the way the dealerships work in the latest update. So, unless the truck has been updated, that dealer fix would need to be created before, so the truck would at least still be able to be used, and until that truck gets updated. saw the truck there, and I figured it was just someone who incorporated the dealer fix with the mod and then put it up there. Viper hasn't released an update as of yet, unless someone else did it and is taking credit for his mod. Generation Scania's got their 8x4, so hopefully here with Oregon, we might get a new truck. Again, who knows what the hell SCS is going to do. And then also, the European truck racing season is just about starting, and guess who has another World of Trucks event where ATS gets left out one more time? Let's see what we got here in Albuquerque. We're gonna need something with doubles, so I'm not sure if I want to go down to Carlsbad. That's 311. That's normally a little bit too long for a day cabber to go. These guys are usually stuck in probably 200 miles of their home base. Well, Sholo would work, picking up at BNSF and taking it over to FedRex. Although that's a reefer, and I don't believe the trailer mods that I'm running will allow for Old Dominion on a reefer, so we're not going to take that one. And that's just getting longer and longer there, so it looks like we are going to be going down to Carlsbad. Guys are not seeing anything I had mentioned earlier. This is a 4x2 chassis. granted, Old Dominion in the real world, they basically run Freightliners and T680s. I could not find a T680 on this skin, so we are kind of stuck with the 579 today. Going on with the trailers now. I have a flatbed mod and that is a spread axle. And I just looked at this like, okay, I know how that a spread axle turns, so it looks like that's what might also be causing the issue that I'm having with Greyhound buses. On that. And it definitely gets me when I look into the mirrors. I'm used to seeing tandems running on the back of me, not just a single axle. So that kind of looks a little weird for me after having those tandems on in the game for so long, and then finding a 4x2 that actually works. But it's still gonna sit there. I'm going by you. It's just causing way too much crap to go on. And then he backs into me. It's like, really? Holy sh... Yeah, I'm not gonna say it. I'm gonna be nice. and I'll watch my load disappeared too. Oh no, it didn't. Holy... Wow, I am surprised. Roger that on the grillin'. Make sure you leave some dinner for me, that's for sure. I did go ahead and deactivate the enhanced 579 for this stream, only because when I had it activated, I could not get this 579 set up. course, it happened to be a Schneidermobile that caused me to slam on my brakes. Yes, I did. You had dropped off the trailer. When you went back into the game, you fell through. Way to go, Coda. Learn to talk. That does sound absolutely delicious. I'll be right down. Take Coast to Coast out for this stream, but if it was in there, I definitely would have grabbed a load to Austin. This way, guess what? We get to go through your favorite city. City. Oh, and you had linked my Penske stream that I did. Well, I've got something a little bit different than a Penske for the next time that Iron Man buys me a truck. Oh, way to go, Wiley Sanders. Yeah, I definitely need to take out that traffic mod. That's happening way too much. I'm just gonna save this right here and get that taken out. It is causing way too many problems. Alright, once we get back into the game, we should be able to get the truck started and move right away because there's gonna be no traffic. Hey, give me a moment, guys. My game just crashed, which is that's been happening to me lately when I take out a mod. Yeah, we are definitely going to be doing a convoy soon. Been keeping them quite busy, I bet. Surprise you with the Iron Man bought me a truck tomorrow then. Too. That thing is a moving hazard. I figured that's probably why I have a stack of speeding tickets sitting on my desk. LeVar, good evening. How are you doing today? Oh yeah, I love getting those driving awards every now and then too. They are quite fun. Is it going to be one of those rider rentals? Today we're taking a grand tour of New Mexico featuring Old Dominion. This company was founded in 1934. It started with one truck that ran an 80-mile route. Just last year, Old Dominion received their 15,000th Freightliner, and it was a day cab 2018 version. Roger that on the Discord. Yeah, we are in a 579, a 4x2 today. Asking what a 4x2 is? Well, that's only one set of duals on the back. Now, for those of you who are looking to download this 4x2, it is on the SCS forums in the truck models. George, how are you doing today? are not required, no, as long as they have a city horn. But if a truck does have them, they do need to be functioning. How's it going today? Oh, well, oh, Bobby, all right. Hey, what's going on? What's your question? GTM Mike's, the T-800. Yes, I did download it. That, and they are quite noticeable when the drivers do blow them too. One second, George, I'll get back to you on that one. So the 131 update isn't downloading? This is the game that you're talking about, not like a mod, right? Hey, what do you know? Zombies ahead. Alright, go ahead, right click on ATS, go to Properties, click on Local Files, and then verify the integrity. Yeah, ETS has gotten a couple of updates since we had actually gotten ours. And holy moly, lag spike. What the heck is going on here? Alright, something is like really causing my game to go from where I normally sit at FPS and lagging like the dickens. We're gonna pull over up here. I'm gonna have to restart the game because right now this is like totally unplayable. All one second here. That might have actually disappeared. Let's go ahead and do a run. Start out driving here and see if we get any further lag. I went from 90 FPS down to 25. So I am not sure what happened there, and it looks like it cleared up. So either something's going on there with one of the mods that I'm running, or there is a memory leak somewhere right around in Artesia. I never checked it during pre-trip, George. One thing you want to look up is search for Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration, or FMCSA. There is a big old handbook to where you can search through to see if that is required. Because to be honest with you, I never checked it. A memory leak is what would actually cause a game to go from 90 FPS down to 25, and then have like you guys might have not have seen it, but it was very noticeable on my side to where the game started stuttering. Simple search, instead of going into the FMCSR or FMCSA, I can't remember what the heck it is anymore. Just do a search for pre-tip inspection for 18-wheeler. And then you should find a list of everything that a driver should be checking. Now, I don't believe the DOT is going to fine you for having a non-functioning air horn. When I was DOT checked, they didn't check it. So, I mean, you might get a idiot for a DOT inspector who might, but the majority of them are not going to say a thing. FMCSR, so Federal Motor Carrier Safety Regulations, is what that is. If I said A in there, I do apologize. Don't believe that they do. I would imagine it's going to be, once we get a confirmation it's in closed beta, we will pretty much have a release in 4 to 6 weeks. Alright, let's get our next job here from Carlsbad. Where can we go? None of these trailers here will have a doubles option. So, it looks like there's nothing down here. Let's check the external contracts to see if we can find something that has an Old Dominion trailer. If not, not sure what we're going to do. We just may take a quick trip somewhere else. Doesn't look like we are getting anything there, so we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna do a quick travel back up to Santa Fe, and then we should be all right. Coda, what are you doing? You shouldn't have shut the truck off. Now, you are making my mouth water with brisket. I want some too. Well, there is an Old Dominion in Harrisburg in Pennsylvania, and all they do in there is all LTL freight. They pull doubles, and then they do have some 53-foot dry vans too. Alright, so let's see what we got here in Santa Fe. We've got Tucumcari. What else do we got? We should be able to make Flagstaff from here, Gallup, Farmington. And everything else is too far, so we're going to go ahead. We're going to go over to Tucumcari. No, we're not, actually, as a matter of fact. We're going to take this load of empty pallets for $20,000. We are going to go over to Flagstaff. And don't worry that that trailer said Swift. We are definitely not pulling a Swift trailer. George, you take care. No, I don't have any DLCs for ETS2 with the exception of special transport. Hey, how about this? We get the Roadrunner Express coming through. Skin Martin, I just haven't decided when I'm gonna do another Martin stream. Oh, holy moly, again? And that's twice in a row when it's been my turn to turn left. that we've got stuck here. Alright, maybe my game doesn't like me. Alright, one thing I am going to take a look and see if I have a 53 in Old Dominion. I don't believe I do. And no, I don't, because if I did, it would be right in here. So, no Old Dominion on the 53s. Let's go ahead and check our combined trailers or doubles. And we should be able to select that, I hope. If not, we will pull a Walmart trailer. Yep, how about that? No, we're just gonna do a plain Jane. How about that? We've got a brand new trailer that hasn't been skinned yet. That's what we're gonna do on this one. Thank you. likely, I am not LeVar. What AI? What do you mean? Start Steam to see if you can force it to go ahead and start the download. If it says update queued, once you restart Steam, it should download. The truck itself, I wasn't even paying attention. Lights were square on that cab over, it more than likely would have been a K100. Yes, it has been forever. How you been? And I have been doing awesome. Have you found anything that you liked? Roger that, and welcome back, Grim. It's great to see you again. I'm not going to climb over into that seat over there. Hoping once Oregon comes out, we're definitely going to get a version update at that time. So we're probably going to go to 132 unless they have some really major bug fixes coming. And hopefully with that update, if we're lucky, we'll get a new truck. Which one? I have no idea. And then we'll get all these signs in the game fully updated. Because now that we're going to have New Mexico and Oregon on their new signage, there are parts of California that were fixed with this update, but I would love to see every exit in California, Nevada, and Arizona updated. And if you guys were wondering where those signs are in California, mostly on the I-5, right around the San Francisco, Oakland, Sacramento area is where I saw the majority of. I got it back roughly about 7 days later. Haven't had an issue with it since. What Paul from Tech Affliction had mentioned to me is when he got in there and took a look, one of the sensors got whacked out of alignment, and I am not even sure how that had happened. But pretty much, he got that fixed and sent it back to me, and even refunded me for my shipping costs. guys are going to be ordering a shifter, I am, of course, going to recommend Tech Affliction. However, if you didn't want to wait the lead time, which is 20-25 days, and want one in 3 or 4, there is the Simu shift knob, which is available on Amazon, but definitely stay away from CSIO. That is a possibility, Martin. I knew the truck wasn't updated. What they might have incorporated, though, with the one that you had downloaded was his fix in order to get the truck to show in the 131 update. That's the only thing I can think of. Welcome, Bobby. And now that the Truckers MP has been updated for 131, I'm probably going to do a public convoy next week. Whoa, holy shnikes, what the hell, Smokey Bear? Are you serious? Good thing I looked over and saw him, otherwise I would have had myself a nice little violation. Hey, Killer Kid, how you doing today? I kind of want to wait for the US server to get back on the line also. Apparently it's being updated and there is no word on when it is going to be back, but that's the rumor going around. LeVar, you're going to want to download the Truckers MP app. So go to truckersmp.com and you can download the installer. And definitely create a second profile specifically for multiplayer, as mods do not work there. Little 4x2, get your butt up and go, go, go! Well, I can only go 65, but yeah. I can't even remember what the heck I just said, what you're referring to there. Oh, about the Trucker's MP, creating a second profile. It's definitely recommended if you're worried about money and XP. There is a program called Cheat Engine that you can use to hack the profile for literally money and XP. So you can buy all your garages and whatnot. And the reason for that second profile is to avoid any conflict with a single player profile. One thing, Bobby, since you're moving to 1.31, Coast to Coast has been updated for version 2.5, which works on 1.31. You're going to want to download that. If you are running any mod trucks, what you currently have bought will still work. However, you will not see any new trucks in the dealership's mods until they have been updated. That would be Trucks Book there, Martin, and I do not use it as it's used for tracking loads of someone in your company. We do not have new trucks as of yet. In a recent SMS AMA, SCS AMA, they had mentioned about negotiations with 1 to 2 manufacturers going extremely well. And my guess is that's going to be Freightliner and Volvo Mack. And with Oregon coming out later on this year, Daimler Freightliner is essentially headquartered in the United States in Springfield, Oregon, I believe. So if one of those is happen to be a Freightliner, we may have to wait a little bit on Oregon for a licensing deal to get finalized if they are going to release it with Oregon. Yeah, you're gonna want to download now, LeVar. no idea. Your guess would be as good as mine. Yeah, if your profile is private on Steam, LeVar, what you're going to want to do is make your inventory and your profile public just so you can set the game to Truckers MP. You would then be able to hide it once again. Serpentine on your back and get in there nice and straight. You know how to do it. What do we got here in Flagstaff? Wow, there's like nothing here being local. That is very weird. All right, Roger that, Lieutenant Colonel. You have a good one. Well, let's see if we got anything here in external contracts. And absolutely nothing. Could take this used packaging up over to Las Vegas. And granted, they don't haul. That's probably a rail trailer to begin with, so that's probably not a good idea. And since this is a day cab, roughly these guys don't go 200 to 300 miles outside of their home location. Catch you on the flippity flop there, Lieutenant Colonel. Oh, there's one there. We should be able to change that. Clovis, that will work for us. And you idiot, you clicked on the wrong one. There we go. good. Good old classic Old Dominion here with a set of LTL doubles behind you. Miles, how are you doing this Friday evening? Oh boy, don't get stuck, don't get stuck, don't get stuck. Whoo, made it. Have some too? Just left Flagstaff. We are heading east on Interstate 40 and we are going to be going all the way over to Clovis. Oh wow, that's a nasty four vehicle wreck. Remembered, we got the Packard, holy Packard, the MX-13, and we've got, that's at 515 horsepower, and then we've got a 10-speed transmission today. Oh, of course, yeah, I'm home. If I'm not home, I'm not streaming. What do you mean, Miles? Yeah, I live in the USA. And the map that we're running today is just the base map along with the New Mexico DLC, of course. Jumping in the hammer lane, I have no idea. We're probably gonna get pulled into the way station up here. Yes, LeVar. did you create an account with Truckers MP before you tried to install that? Create an account with Truckers MP first. Just in order to discover the game, and in order to get that set up, you would then be able to move that back to private, or however you had it set beforehand. that could be a possibility, yeah. Are you searching the proper location for the game files, LeVar? Yeah, the T-800 was kind of snuck in there, wasn't it? Because I wasn't expecting it either. We've got eight loves in the game. What I suggest, LeVar, is search on YouTube for how to install Truckers MP, because I cannot remember the exact steps. It's been over a year since I installed it. I do have the Wabash trailer mod, and what one of those that I do have activated is the AI traffic. So I've been seeing them, although I really haven't been paying a whole lot of attention to them either. It's alright, the sound on it isn't the greatest even with Creechbomb's engines, but it's not bad. Hey Kurtley, how you doing today? And there's absolutely nothing wrong with using a PACCAR engine. No, you are not seeing anything. That is a 4x2 that I am running. They're not a bad engine at all. I just prefer myself, I prefer Cummins. The only thing that would be different from Old Dominion in the real world is they would not, I believe they have some 579s, but most of their day cabs are either Cascadias or T680s. But I definitely don't mind running a day cab or the 579. Even though PACCAR isn't my favorite engine, I had absolutely no problem with it today. I got the Transcraft one. I do know there is a Mac flatbed that was just released also. But anyways, guys, I am going to get on out of here for the rest of this Friday evening. I do want to thank you for watching. If you did enjoy today's live stream, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And this 4x2 mod for the chassis, it is available under the SCS forums underneath American Truck Simulator, Mods, and Models. There is a link, I believe, on the second page of that thread that you would be able to download. But I do hope you guys have a great rest of your Friday. This is Coda signing off. We will see you guys on the Flippity Flop.